When the earth was created, the water was already there, was covered with water, and the storms were already there. And man has no control over these things, and they have no pity for the human condition, and there is a powerful force. And the crows had reverence for it, but fear, not a peaceful reverence for it, but out of fear. And whatever lives in the water is potentially dangerous to the crows, because whatever, it's a dangerous environment, and whatever lives down there is potentially dangerous. And doesn't pity the human condition. Anything down there might eat people or kill and destroy them. And they talk about a water beast called Buluksa, and there's no equivalent in English. And I've seen it in 1986, right about this time in June. And when they talk about these beasts, the old people used to say, when rose hips are in bloom, stay out of the water, because that's when they have their young and they are the most dangerous. And so I always thought it was some kind of a mythical being that they used to scare children from swimming in when the water is high and it's dangerous. Along Prayer Creek here used to be a railroad line, and that they tore it down and abandoned it in the 1880s. And from that point, they made it into a road that intersects with the Bellings to Hardin Road. And it was used as a stagecoach line from Bellings to Prayer. In 1910, my grandfather and my father were in that stagecoach, and where in this marshy place here behind me, just as they were approaching it, my grandfather was telling a story about a water beast that lived in a marshy place there. And he described it. He said it's about 12 feet long, and the color is black in the bottom, and yellow on the sides, and light green in the area, and then dark green on top. So it was you can hardly see it when it's in the water. And as he was talking about it, they approached this marshy area right behind me. And when they were coming up, the beast was coming up, and it was approaching the road. And they could see the front end of his body, and also his tail. And so they stopped to look at it, and he said it had huge round face that looked almost human. And he said that he had nostrils, tiny nostrils, that he probably closes when it's in the water, and slits. Eyeballs are slits, and they almost look human, and it didn't blink, and his eyeballs were yellow in color. And he said his teeth were long. They stuck out of his mouth real long. And then he had arms. The front end had arms that looked like human arms. And they were muscled. They were huge muscles on it. And then his fingers looked like human fingers, but they're shorter and stubbier, and with long claws. And his neck is long, and it's thin. It sort of tapers off at the head, and then it gets bigger when it touches the body. And he said, I could see a knot on top of his forehead that was about a fingernail. And then he said, as I could see it, the knots on his forehead got bigger, until at the very top of his head they were as big as a human hand, and then they got smaller again as it approached the tail. And he said it looked very dangerous. He said it looked powerful. His legs, his arms were powerful. And after my dad saw this, nobody had seen it again until. And he used to tell me stories. And whenever I came by here, I would think that I would see it. And then in 1986, we had a tobacco ceremony in Crow Agency. It was Corpus Christi, and we camped there at the fairgrounds. And when after Corpus Christi, we came back, and as we were coming in, as we were approaching this area from the east end, we saw something along the road. And at first, I thought it was a dog with a long tail. And then I said, "What is it? There's something on here that I've never seen before." So as we approached it, I immediately recognized it. It was this water beast. It was about 12 feet long and had a round head. And I didn't see the face because it was almost on the other side of the road. And just as my dad describes it, there were knots on his back and on top of his head. They're small, but they get bigger until in the back they get real as big as a human hands. And then they get smaller again until they come to the end of his tail. When I saw it from the rear and also from the side. And the front end is lower. The front end is lower, and the back is much higher, and his hind legs are much higher. And then his tail is about 6 feet long, but it's tapered and it's big. They're rounded and they're big. And an alligator drags his tail when he's walking. And this one didn't. The tail was up and like it was well balanced. And it was walking real slow, and we stopped and looked at it. And at first I was gonna jump off and see what it really looked like. But then we fear these things because they have spiritual powers, not spiritual, but energy. They can make the rivers rise and they can do damage with the water that they're in to people. So I just stayed in the car and watched it, and it finally walked. It was watching towards the west, towards the mountains. It was looking that way, and then it approached on the end of the river, and then it went into Prayer Creek. People used to talk about this, and I thought they were just saying it so that we would not go swimming when the river is high. But these things are real, and I've seen it myself.